Happy Friday. Welcome back to BT Vancouver. 9:23 right now. When the pandemic started weeks ago, we connected with a teacher living in Italy to see what life was like under strict quarantine and self-isolation. We're going to do a bit of an update right now and bring in our good friend Sebastiano Bazzichetto and talk about what life is like in Italy right now as we're getting ready to reopen some regional areas. Welcome back to BT, my friend.
Hello, good morning, how are you?
I'm doing great, thank you. And it's in the evening, your time there right now. Now on Monday, some of the regional governments in Italy have announced that they will be reopening things like bars, restaurants, hairdressers. What's your reaction to that right now?
Well, I think, you know, the whole point is that we don't have a clear idea about how to deal with the so-called second phase. We received guidelines already, of course, but we don't really know how they will unfold in reality. I guess it will depend on the individual's goodwill and good sense, you know.
And when we first talked to you, as I mentioned, you couldn't even go 200 meters from your home. You could be fined or jailed. What's the atmosphere like right now on the streets, and are you even getting out that much these days?
Well, in a way, we are. We have a dog, so we always go out to walk the dog, of course. Yes, sure, we can see our kind of extended family, as you may know. Mm-hmm. But except for that, nothing has really changed. I mean, I think that police, for example, are increased, actually, to check all the unnecessary movements of people. I think it's a very delicate phase, so we cannot jeopardize the efforts and the sacrifices that we have done in the past 2+ months, right? So, of course, we are still wearing masks and we still use gloves mm-hmm. if, you know, we have to go to the post office or the supermarket and the like.
So you're near Venice. When you're out in the streets among the public, are there a lot of people wearing masks like yourself? And what's the general atmosphere like? Is it still kind of tense?
It is still kind of tense. And I have to say that probably 99% of the people are still wearing masks and gloves. And actually, it's kind of weird to see someone who is not wearing a mask. You know what I mean? It's mm-hmm. it's that kind of situation. The atmosphere is tense. We don't really know what to expect. We don't know what's going to happen to us. So it's not the easiest moment for the country.
What's been the biggest challenge for you personally going through all this? Because we're coming up on like 2 months now, and it's been just kind of a new routine and a new way of life for people all over the world. So how has it mainly affected you?
Well, I think, you know, throughout these 2.5 months, there has always been some kind of anticipation, but also caution. And all of this has become a new reality, mm-hmm. but it has affected, you know, each and every one of us psychologically also, you know. And I can't wait to travel again, to visit my friends, of course, all over the peninsula. But in a way also to rediscover once again my beautiful country. We are not made and meant for solitude, I think, as human beings.
I know, it's like we're all in captivity like caged animals. Other than traveling, what else are you looking forward to once everything reopens?
So, you know, just spending some real good time with my good friends in the flesh, you know, just to enjoy each other's company and human presence. Again, Honoré de Balzac said, solitude is fine, but you need someone to tell that solitude is fine. So I really need someone in the flesh to tell that solitude is not fine and wasn't fine all this time.
I hear you. As we close things out, when you first appeared on our show, and you'll forgive the expression, you were sort of like the Italian canary in the coal mine, talking about the impending situation that was coming, some prognosticator of doom. So now that things are a little bit better, what is your message to Canadians from Italy?
I think it's just, you know, keep wearing the masks, keep wearing the gloves, keep doing social distancing, but Canadians are usually very good at that. And I think in a couple of months, we'll be able to travel again between our two great countries.
Amazing. Good to talk to you, and stay safe in Italy there, Sebastiano.
You too. Thank you so much.
All right. You take care. That's Sebastiano Bazzichetto near Venice in Italy with a nice update there on how life is during the pandemic as things begin to slowly reopen. We'll have more BT.